Hey guys, my name is Nick. I'm from ETC New York, and this is Eos 2.6. We have a lot of new features to talk about. Let's dig in. There are a lot of new display options in Eos 2.6. Let's take a look at the first one, which is using About in combination with other keys. We have a lot of new features that will allow you to see what's going on with your data. The first button combination is using About and Data. And you'll notice that it will show me all of my levels that are behind manual values. So you can see 36 through 40 have been manually changed. If I want to see what's stored behind there, About Data will temporarily toggle that forward. If you're using part queues, About and Part, it'll expose which part each channel is stored in. So if I page down here, you can see that these channels are all stored in various parts of this queue. And similarly, About queue will show you which queue list is contributing, and this also shows you the part that these channels are stored in. If you have channels that are marked, and you hit About Mark, you can see which queue those channels are marked to. About address will display the address of all of the parameters for your channels. And About and Live will show you the parameter values for each of those parameters. So these are the DMX values that are going out to the rig. And finally, there's been a change. If you want to temporarily toggle your show reference labels, it is now About Label, and that will toggle you back and forth between show reference labels and your target numbers. In previous versions of software, that function was held by Shift Label. Shift Label now gets your queue note on the command line. Keep in mind that pressing and holding About and double hitting any of these will lock that into toggle state, and you can see at the top of the display that pressing About again will release it back to its standard display. The next thing we want to point out that's new in displays are the three shortcuts that are on all of your displays. You'll notice that there's a camera, some moving light beams, and a magic wand. And those pertain to a quick view of your snapshots. So this will show you all the snapshots that exist and allow you to quickly jump to them. Next to that is your ML control. So this is a quick way to just pop down, see your ML control, make a few adjustments, and pop right back out of it. This pop-down works exactly like the standard ML controls. The final shortcut is your new pop-up magic sheet. In here, you can define one of your magic sheets to float above all of your displays. In this example, I built a little preview of my rig. I have a house light fader, and I have a couple of snapshots and command line functions. So this is fully interactive, just like all of your other magic sheets. You can make channel selections, trigger buttons, and then just touch outside to make it go away. Another big change we've made to displays is the ability to set your external monitor arrangement from within the application. If you touch any of your monitor config tools, there's a new option, which is your monitor mapping. And you'll notice what that does is it highlights the current monitor you have selected and allows you to see where they're located in reference to one another. One of the things that was unpredictable in previous versions of software was when you recorded a snapshot, recalling those on the same monitor in different arrangements was difficult to do. Now it's easy to set up your monitors from rig to rig or show to show and have certainty that those things will be recalled on the proper displays. We recommend that when you start setting this up, you work with your leftmost monitor first and work your way across your displays to the right. With the monitor configuration tools in the software, we're able to do a lot more granularity in snapshots now. So I'm going to say record snapshot, and you'll get a little preview of the monitors with a thumbnail of their graphics. Whenever you record a snapshot, we're going to store all of the views, but you have the ability to filter what is recalled. So for example, if I only want to recall my internal monitors, I can quickly touch my externals, and those won't be recalled when I play back this snapshot. There's a lot of options in the new snapshot tool, and for you crazy cats, there's an advanced button. Feel free to explore this feature as you get the time. Also in 2.6, Query has gotten a grow-up package, so really quickly, let's look at that. There's a whole bunch of new logic in Query that allows you to look at things that are blocked, being asserted, marking, captured, tracked, broken marks, etc. So for example, Query marked enter will grab me the channels that are currently marked in this queue. Feel free to explore all the different query options, and don't forget to string them together for extra power. The next improvement in 2.6 software is the introduction of priority mark. Marking will work the way it always has if you choose, but one of the things that we can do now is set mark flags so that a queue can either be a highest priority mark or a lowest priority mark. And this allows us, when not defining a queue number, to have the mark state automatically find the highest, and if it can't mark there, it will automatically mark to the lowest priority. Let's look at a quick example. So the first thing that I want to do is define my mark queues as I'm going. You can see by my labels that the button, Q4, is probably going to be a loud number. Lots of applause, at least we hope. So we're going to say Q4 mark, and you'll notice some priorities here. I want to make this one a high priority. If channels can mark here as I build my queues below, I prefer it. So I'll hit enter, and I get an MH, telling me that this is a mark queue with a high priority. Keep in mind that just like a standard mark, the M is lowercase because nothing is marking to that queue yet. So now I want to define my second choice if channels can't mark to that button. I'm going to go ahead and say Q6 mark low priority. And that's going to give me an ML for mark low priority. And any channels that aren't able to mark in 4 will now mark in 6. So I'm going to go to Q8. And as I start to build my show, I'm going to go ahead and say 31 through 35 at full. I'm going to put those into a color. And I know that I want to mark these before they come on into Q9. So I'm going to say select last, mark, enter. And because I haven't defined a queue, it's going to look for high priority mark queues first. And if it can't mark to those queues, it will find the low priority mark queue. So if I record Q9, we can see with about mark that those channels are marking in Q4, which is my high priority, and my M in Q4 has turned capitalized, noting that there are channels marking in that queue. We've made a nice little improvement to language in our pop-up keyboard. If I go to label something, I've always had the ability to change my language by clicking the flag in the lower right-hand corner. But now instead of toggling through those, it's a pop-up, so I can get to those languages more quickly than before. Thanks for checking out all the new 2.6 features. And Element users, a special heads up, all of this and a lot more is coming to you in 2.6. We've unlocked a lot of the top-level features that are in Eos Family Desks, so be sure when you upgrade to keep track of your manual, your supplements, and check out the forums. There's a lot of new stuff. We hope you like it. As you can see, there's a lot of stuff in 2.6, but we haven't covered everything. So be sure to check out your supplement, read the manual, and check us out on etcconnect.com for all the latest information. From Middleton, this is Nick. See you at the next one.